Wonderful.
I can sense, and from where I am, I can spot extra glows on faces in this room. And I think we should take further advantage. And in case there are questions, could they ask you? All right, so here is His Holiness, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. We have time for 3 questions, I'm told. So if you want to ask something, this is your chance. Mics will reach where you are. Who would like to ask him the very first question? I think you have given them complete knowledge. This total transfer, this gyan. But if you really want to ask him, this is the time. Yes, could we have a mic reach him, the very first row? A request to everybody, please introduce yourself and keep the question short.
I'm P.K. Das, Director for Software Technology Parks of India in Bangalore. In fact, Guruji doesn't have a question. I got the answer. That's why I'm revealing that I got the answer here. I have been trying to find, having reading books, listening to people, that we should try to live on now, rather than being in the past or in the future. But how to live on now was a big question. I think during this short session, I felt like being in your
In the present presence,
moment. In your presence, yes, sir. Living in the presence. Thank you.
Okay. Very well put. Thank you so much. Yes, if you could stand up, the mic would reach you.
I really experienced yoga for last 2 weeks. I'm here with my family and with Guruji today, another experience. And I feel like if this is the practice, it's been followed in our school system, it would really benefit, you know, and will train our youth, you know, in a tremendous way. Thank you.
Yeah, we are doing, no, we are giving, we are running 423 free schools around the country for the poor and disadvantaged people. And you'll see the brilliance. About 50,000 kids are studying and the tremendous amount of transformation in them. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Now we have also come up, I would like to say one something very exciting for you. We have started with the one thing called the intuition process for kids between 8 and 18. No, you cannot play around with those kids now anymore. They know all the secret. Their intuition becomes so sharp. They can see, suppose you have misplaced something and you are searching for it, your kids will tell you where exactly you have kept it. And they know what questions are coming today in the question paper. They even tell the parents what Gurudev is going to talk this evening in the discourse. And it's tremendous amount. You know, we have only read in books the third eye opening, third eye and all. I tell you, it is possible. It is really the inner technology, actually. Helping people open up their inner mind, the eye of the mind, is something that's working now. You can go into a Facebook and see how blind children are able to also identify things. This is going to change the face of education in the planet. Revolution in education.
Guruji, I have the mic. Guruji, you know, as you know, in Bangaloreans spend at least 2 to 3 hours on the road, you know, doing what? So if you can give a technique for meditation while driving, especially stuck in traffic.
See, people from the hardware sector are very smart with their questions, Your Holiness.
See, do you brush your teeth while driving? No. So I would not ask you to do meditation while you are driving, but if you are riding in the car behind, you can definitely do. But while driving, you can listen to some knowledge, you know. Simple thing, when you are in the car, just know that your life is like the car. You should have the windshield like the present and the future, and you should look at the back like the back mirror and side mirror, like looking to the past and to the sides, you know, comparing with others. but you should, your sight should be as wide as the windshield. Yeah.
Great. I see a lady. Could you please give the mic to her?
Often people do the other way around. They keep looking at the rear mirror more than the windshield.
Namaskara Guruji. I'm Manjula. I'm from RV Velasai. Guruji, I have a question for you. Of late that I see, although the strength of our country is the youth, but then I see the strength mentally of the youth these days is a little weaker. All the time they are into the competition and I see they get frustrated very fast. And I want to understand what should be your message for the youth, for the stamina, which is called as patience and self-motivation for achievements.
Yoga. They should do yoga, meditation, and engage in social service activities that broadens their vision, you know. Otherwise, these days you hear a lot more of schizophrenia, bipolar, attention deficiency syndrome. These words we have never heard when we were growing up. And these are because too much pressure on the mind, not enough energy to sustain or act accordingly. Yeah.
Thank you, Guruji.
I think one last question. There's time for just one last question. Is that okay?
It's okay. There are two. We can take two more.
Great.
The mind is calm and serene. Whatever you say, it goes directly in and we are able to do that. The problem is, how do I stay focused during the time when there's turmoil going on and I'm really going back and forth, and at that point of time, I'm really not able to concentrate. And that's where, when the challenge I get in, I'm absolutely out.
This is where breath helps. Breath is the link between body and mind. And it's half subtle and half gross. So using breath as a tool, you can calm your mind very quickly. You cannot directly handle the mind because it's so abstract. Breath comes to your help. Sudarshan Kriya is one such technique. It immediately brings you to the moment.
Thank you.
Was there one last?
Guruji, namaste.
Most
of us executives are torn between two extremes, making it happen and letting it go. How does one strike the right balance between?
Just wanting to have the balance itself puts them in balance. If they just realize this very fact that we are either in this way or on that, that itself can bring them to the center.
I think with that we come to the end of the question session, but Guruji, nankadeinda on prashne agbahuda. Moderator's perk. I just wanted to ask you, and I have always been curious, how do you draw yourself off from these gadgets? This, you know, phone and Facebook you mentioned. I want to be able to advise my son, but the mother herself is not very good at it.
Virtual world is essential. Technology, Facebook, phone is all okay. It's nothing wrong. But have some time away from this. Going to sports or watching the nature or taking some time off for yourself to do exercise. Then there is a red button. Sometime you have to use that also.
Great. This session has been useful for me. Thank you so much, organizers. Thank you so much, His Holiness Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. One question?
Please allow me to ask one question.
Yes, he's all yours.
Guruji, I'm Nitin. When we see a lot of violence in the world, can you able to initiate a conference of fanatics to sort out this kind of violence which ISIS and all other similar kind of organizations are spreading?
We have been doing effort. We have done some effort. You might have known about the FARC, which have been 50 years of war was there in Colombia, you know, where we made some effort on that and we were quite successful. In Kashmir, in 2000, it was impossible to go around without a gunman or some protection around. Today, the situation has changed. Hundreds and thousands of Naxal people involved in Naxal movement have surrendered. Even this morning, I had a meeting with the Manipur militant organization. Ulfa people, I have met them. You know, it's communication. When we are there to hear them, it's all, you know, either they have some deep scars, wounds, which they are unable to get over, which can be healed. But as far as ISIS is concerned, it seems to be very difficult. I had offered to talk to them, but they sent me a different kind of letter, which you all know. So.
Well, here's hoping the tone of that letter changes over time. We live in hope. I now request Vinay Shenoy to kindly honor His Holiness Sri Sri Ravi Shankar with a shawl. Thank you so much, Gurudev, for your presence. It's truly benefited this gathering in a very different manner, in a much, much more deeper, engaging way, and we are grateful to you for this. Thank you so much. Dhanyavaad. Mr. Vinay, in fact, I think many thanks to be said, and I would urge you to say a vote of thanks.
Yeah, again, Gurudev ji, thank you for sparing your valuable time with us. The experience that we have derived with just 10 minutes of meditation, I can still see some people trying to continue with that experience, and insightful questions from you all. So I think we have appealed to the spiritual mind within you. I thank you for enlightening us that much more. And it's an honor to have Gurudev Ravi Shankar with us amongst our midst. Thank you very much, sir, again. We are blessed.